have a favorite animal? I went through many favorite animals when I was a kid. The velvet ant, the sea pig, silky bantam chickens. Okay, that one might actually still be my favorite. What I loved most, though, was collecting facts about different animals. I mean, I really enjoyed it. I could tell you how much a silky bantam chicken weighs, on average, or where you would find a sea pig. But of course, one fact to always know about your favorite animal is what your favorite animal eats. Are they herbivores, which means they eat plants? Carnivores, which means they eat meat? Omnivores, which means they eat meat and plants? And there are more categories than this. Even though all my favorite animals ate different things, they all had one thing in common. They were all heterotrophs. Generally, animals are heterotrophs, which means they consume organic matter. It doesn't matter whether they are eating plants, meat, or both. They are heterotrophs, also known as consumers. Along with animals being heterotrophs, so are fungi, some protists are heterotrophs, and some bacteria, and some archaea too. But not everything on this planet is a heterotroph. Do you have a favorite plant? That may be less popular than having a favorite animal. Plants are generally autotrophs, which means they make their own food. To be more specific, they make organic substances, such as glucose, from inorganic substances, such as carbon dioxide. If talking about plants, their source of energy to do this is light. Plants are also known as producers. Their food is glucose, an organic substance, which they produce in the process of photosynthesis by using inorganic substances such as carbon dioxide. Oh, and even the plants known as carnivorous plants still produce their own food using photosynthesis. It's just that carnivorous plants can also digest insects to obtain nitrogen. Nitrogen is an important element that living organisms need, and it turns out that most carnivorous plants live in areas where there is low nitrogen in the soil. Along with plants, some protists are autotrophs. Some bacteria and some archaea are too. Now, it's also possible that an organism itself can be both an autotroph and a heterotroph. In our protist video, we talk about Euglena. Euglena can do photosynthesis as autotrophs, but they can also be heterotrophs and consume organic matter in cases where life is not available. So far, we've been pretty general.